camel shouts and bubba kush.
It seems to me like every summer we go through this phase that we like to call breakup season. And most of the people I know are going through that right now, including myself. And, you know, I've been asking about it. I've been doing like most of us do and talking to God about it and asking, you know, for guidance and to show me, you know, what he wants me to do, who I'm supposed to be with. Because, you know, as a lot of you who follow me or have me on live profile or whatever know, I'm ready for a family. I'm ready for, you know, all of that. Like, I'm ready. So I thought. Okay, so naturally I asked God for these things, and like they say, asking you shall receive. I had this feeling to go to church, and so a friend of mine took me to church, and lo and behold, I feel like the message was specifically for me, and my friend also, because, you know, like I said, all my friends are going through the same thing right now. And so anyhow, I went to this church, and the minister, the pastor, the preacher, the bishop, the whatever, the head of the church guy, you know, his message was about being single and the purpose of being single. And he was saying that a lot of times, you know, we tend to ask God for someone, for that special someone in our lives, and a lot of the time why we're single is because we have a few things that we need to work on. And the best way that he put it that I can remember was that, you know, every time you let someone into your heart and they leave it, they leave scars, they leave bruises, they leave pain, sorrow, and all of these type of things and emotions and things, you know, that we refer to now as baggage. And this is not something that you want to bring into your next relationship, because in a sense, you're damning your relationship before it begins. This time that you're by yourself and that you're single is supposed to be a reevaluation period. It's supposed to be a point where you fix the things that have been broken from your previous relationship. If you, for example, know that you have anger issues, short temper, like I do, then this is the time that you work on that. This is the time where you build your patience, and your patience will be tested. And until you pass these tests, you're going to keep redoing it. That's the way life goes. It's a series of tests. And once you pass these tests after studying and paying attention, then you move on to the next step, which in this case would be that, I don't want to say married life, but, you know, that commitment and that serious relationship. But when you take the test and you fail, you continue to take the test until you pass. This is why a lot of us feel like, why do I keep dating this person? Or why do I keep thinking I'm with someone good and it never works out? Or why do these things keep happening to me? Or whatever. Because there's a lesson here that you haven't learned yet. And until you stop being selfish and allow His will to be done, you're not going to get it. Bottom line, what you work on. These are the things that you need to steady and have for your foundation upon your next relationship. If you are the type of person who gives it up too easy, you meet someone and you sleep with them on the first night, know that they are falling, if they fall in love with you, they're falling in love with your body. They're falling in love with the physical aspects of you because you have not allowed them to understand, get to know, or even preview the mental, emotional, spiritual part of you. And this is the part of you that builds relationships, long-lasting relationships. I can't express this enough. The first date sets the precedence of the entire relationship. And if you don't believe me, think back. Think about your past relationships and how you met and what your first date was like, and then how your relationship ended, or what your future dates were like, or so on and so forth. Stop being so typical. Stop rushing to get into a relationship because you're scared to be alone. We're supposed to be alone for a reason, okay? You can't expect perfect if you're not working on perfect. And I know a lot of people, you know, are under the impression there's no such thing as perfect, blah, blah, blah. Bullshit. We're all children of God. And God don't make mistakes. So that being said, honey, we're all perfect. Or at least we're all striving for perfect. We're perfect at the moment we are. But that doesn't mean we can't get better. So reevaluate your definition of perfect and work on it. Work at it. Because when you love yourself, other people love you more. Other people love you as well. When you have certain standards for yourself and you treat yourself with a certain amount of respect, self-respect, then you get respect. And this is another thing that underlines the foundation, a great foundation of an amazing relationship. Everything happens for a reason. Everything that we are is derived from somewhere. It comes from something, whether it be our upbringing, our parents, the schools we went to, the influences of our friends, the environment that we put ourselves in, broken hearts, anger, whatever. Everything comes from somewhere. Find its origin, and if it's a problem, fix it. Okay? We should not, as children of God, be insecure. We're all made the way we are, and again, God don't make mistakes. So love yourself, and then you'll find someone to love you, if that makes sense. I don't know. I'm not a relationship expert or none of that nonsense, but what I can say is I've never been a hoe hopper, so I've never, you know, went from one person to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next, blah, blah, blah. That's not me. I've always been in long-term relationships, and that's the way I like it. I'm a Libra. Like, we function better that way as a team. It's just really unfortunate because if we happen to run across somebody that tips our scales the wrong way, then you got to go. That's all. Yeah, because Libras don't do imbalance. It doesn't go that way. Okay? That's all. So once you guys work on yourselves and fix the things that you don't like about yourselves, or fix the things that have become problems and obstacles for your relationships, and work on that till you become satisfied, then go out there and find your girl or your boy or whatever it is, and be happy. Don't cluster your relationship with burdens and baggage from past. The past is the past. It's a guideline for us to grow from, not something for us to drag around and use as an excuse not to move forward. Okay? That's all. I think I'm going to keep informing you guys at the end of my videos that knowledge is power, because it really is. Like, it really is. You should get you some.
But it's life. Now somebody tell them hoes I'm single for the night. I'm single, nigga had to cancel that bitch like Nino. I ain't trippin' on nothing. I'm sippin' on something, and my homeboy say he got a bad bitch for me. And I'm single, yeah, I'm single, and I'm single, tonight I'm single, and I ain't trippin' on nothing. I'm sippin' on something, and my homeboy say he got a bad bitch for me tonight. Put your hands up. If you're single, put your hands up.